step on the back of fail. Can't cut it short, cause I just see what we feel. If you don't know this, I better you not talk. Light or dark, the journey never stops. It goes on and on and on. But I know fruit, Jaja will deliver me.
Harry Chase studio now, and we're looking forward to a really nice session with our brother Delus, and gonna talk to Stephen Stewart, who is the owner of Harry Chase studio, and maybe we heard that some legends gonna pass by for a nice recorded session afterwards, so let's see what's going on.
I'm Stephen Stewart. We're here at Harry Chase studios in Kingston, Jamaica. I am presently operating the studios since now 17 years. Well, it's interesting that you said international superstars, because in the day, the other studios, if you understand, multi-track was a big thing. Back in the day, in the 70s, the more tracks you had, it's the more modern, more hip your studio was. And so, when the other studios had 8 and 4 tracks, Harry J took the dive and went and had all of 16 tracks, you know. And so, in that day, having a 16-track recording studio, all the musicians wanted to deal with that kind of technology. And so what we had, you had the hip-hop musicians in that day wanting to deal with the technology and visiting musicians. You had groups coming here to perform here in Jamaica, Stevie Wonder, because of the track count, they felt comfortable coming to record here. Michael Jackson wanted to come and record here. Johnny Nash wanting to come here, Eric Gale wanted it. So these are the foreigners that would want to pass through because of, you know, the track count. Apart from that, there was a lot of emphasis on acoustics and the room sound. And so, you know, there was talk of when they were putting the room together, the engineer went through it, you know, the technician went through and went to the different corners of the room with a little 2-2 pistol and fired the shot and tried to get the acoustics just right. So there was time that went into that side of the room, and so the acoustics, it has a special sound. And you hear it in all of those, you know, in especially from Catch a Fire recordings and Bob Marley, you hear the sound. It's the sound of the room. It's very friendly to vocals. And so we have, I think that's the uniqueness of this, part of this Harry J sound.
Recording in a studio with so much history is like making history from the history what's done already been set. You know, if you know, say legends recording at this studio and make hits. So hopefully my recording now become one of the new legendary hits. You understand?
Engineer acts as engineer producer. A lot of who is called producer, especially in the earlier sessions, just sat back and locked out. The the real people that pushed the session were the engineers, you know? That, yeah man, play that. Yeah man, I love that. All right, give a little, my light a bang there. Or it was the engineer, okay? And so between setting up an echo effect and having the guitar play with the effect that, and creating the sound, a lot of time it was the engineer who helped to produce the session, create the sound.
DJ got lost in you. let's first do the lead part and then we do the chorus. This.
Feel calmer, and that's why me love the marijuana. Yeah, I feel light when I light it up. It make my heavens lighten up day or night. Me still not lighting up. La la la, that is where I wanna be. Yes, it makes my heaviest of stress seem weightless. Up on a country bus, go straight away.
Come with this style, Delus. Good man. Double time thing.
One for me.
Back, 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 back.
To the highest we feel. La 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 la, la 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 la, la 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 la, la la la.
For me to have a good session, it has to be the who first. So other than good, you have the best equipment, and that's only a little part of it. It's the who, you know. It's obviously, if you can have 8 or 9 great who's brains coming together, and the who's coming together in one moment and grooving together, that's first. Then obviously drum sound, you know. If your drum sound is great, that is another, 75% of the interaction. So your drum sound has to be right there. You have to really go through the drums and make sure it's right.
In a studio, there's everything. The engineer is the man, like Steven is the man. And you know, because Steven can make any drum sound good, so I don't worry about the drum set. And with the musician around us, they always make a great session.
The mindset makes the process different. Because we're not able to say, oh, we can just cut and paste, we can loop the guitar part and so on. It makes your attitude to recording different. You know, if we know that everything is linear and not non-linear, it makes you want to make sure, when I say rolling, that my part is linearly correct. From start to finish. Not that, oh, okay, it's okay, just cut the first verse, and you understand your attitude. You know, this is what I see as a difference. You know, it's okay, I can fix it in the edit. It makes your mindset, you know, different in terms of your recording. How you go, that's the main thing I see between the old and new, your mindset, when they walk in the studio, you know, it's a different mindset.
The thing with Jamaica, there's a lot of big bottom women in Jamaica, fat. So you sit on the corner and watch a girl pass by and say, wow, look great. So you go back in the studio and you try to play the rhythm like how you see her walking down the road, you know? So it's just the people in general, and it's like, music in Jamaica is like 24 hours, it doesn't stop. And if you go on the corner, a little man selling the juice, he has his radio playing. He go around the corner, say next man. So that's how we grew up. So it constantly is in our head. And with all these parties going on every night, people just party. I think we are probably the party capital of the world.
The truth is that we're coming back to realizing that the only way it's magic is that when the super minds meet. Things only happen in a great way when all our minds meet, you know? It's the example of this is the Philharmonic. The only way we get that kind of sound is when all these supercomputers meet and sit down. The only way we get a string section to sound the way it does, from my understanding of recording string sections, it's not tracking one or two violinists 48 times to expect it to sound like a whole string section. It is the 12 violinists moving their bow across the string, and they're creating their waves, and the sum total of that in their stroke makes the warmness of that string section. You understand? Not an overdub of the same bow stroke. It sounds like a double track. What I'm trying to say is that we have to do the thing the right way, in the right scale, to get greatness.
We're still at Heritage Studio, where legends like Bonnie Wailer recorded their records. We did have a very nice recording session with our brother Delus, and we were talking to Steven Stewart, who is the engineer of Harry J's, as well as the legend himself, Sly Dunbar, passed by and gave us some words about his work. It was really nice and a pleasure meeting those people.